In this video, I am going to explain anatomy of internal oblique. Internal oblique, which is this muscle. This muscle is one layer deep to external oblique. I am going to explain its origin, insertion, function, and myofascial connection with external oblique. Okay. Origin of this muscle is about this part. Where is it? It is iliac crest. Iliac crest. And this part, this is ASIS. ASIS stands for anterior superior iliac spine. Iliac crest and ASIS. Actually, there is fascial attachment on back part, about this part, which is this part. Okay, this fascia is thoracolumbar fascia. Thoracolumbar fascia. This is it. Origin is iliac crest, ASIS, and thoracolumbar fascia. Now let me explain insertion. Insertion is about this part. Where is it? It's rib 10 through rib 12. Depends on anatomy books. Some books might say rib 9. Some books might say rib 10. In this video, I say rib 10 through rib 12. Okay, and what else? This muscle attaches to myofascia around here, which is rectus sheath. Rectus sheath. Rectus sheath is connective tissue that surrounds rectus abdominis. So this muscle kind of fuses to this myofascia. Okay, and this midline. This is linear alba. Linear alba is from Latin. Linear means line. Alba means white. This is white line, exactly. So, it attaches to linear alba plus pubis. Pubis, okay? Its insertion is very, very wide. This area. Okay? By the way, origin is this part. Now let me explain function of internal oblique. Okay, this is right side of internal oblique. And this is external oblique. What happens when both sides of internal oblique contract? That makes trunk flexion. Trunk flexion, like rectus abdominis does. It's like a sit-up movement, right? Trunk flexion when bilateral sides, both sides contract. What happens when one side contract? That brings to side bend. Side bend. Plus, it can do rotational movement. But question is which way? When right side contracts, that brings trunk to this way. What is this way? What kind of rotation is that? That is right rotation. Right side, right rotation. That means ipsilateral rotation. Ipsilateral rotation. Ipsilateral means same side. Right side, right rotation, ipsilateral, okay? So flexion when both sides contract. When one side contracts, that makes side bend and ipsilateral rotation, okay? Ipsilateral. By the way, what is function of external oblique? Which way does it rotate trunk? That's this way, right? This is left side. When left side contracts, that brings to right side. That's the other side, right? That means it is contralateral rotation. Contralateral means opposite side. External oblique, opposite side. Internal oblique, same side. But I found something interesting thing. Okay, when internal oblique contracts, that makes same side, ipsilateral side. And when external oblique contracts, that brings to contralateral side. This is their rotational movement. But this happens when your pelvis and feet are stabilized. Your feet are on ground. Then they make this kind of rotation. But what if your feet are off ground? Maybe you are hanging down on the bar and your feet are on the air. Then when these guys contract, what's going to happen? Maybe internal oblique can bring this way and external oblique can bring trunk this way. Now, for internal oblique, what kind of rotation is that? That's opposite side, isn't it? This is right side. And this is left rotation, right? Right and left, contralateral. Now, this is left side external oblique. Which way of rotation is that? That is left rotation. That's ipsilateral. So, this is just my hypothesis. So, internal oblique and external oblique both can do both rotation. Depends on feet are on ground or feet are off ground. If somebody personal trainer or strength conditioning trainer are looking this video, and if you are sure about this contraction, please leave a comment. Okay, so this is like an interesting thing. Now let me explain myofascial connection. Again, this is internal oblique. This is external oblique. Look at direction of fiber. They kinda match, right? They both run this way. So there is myofascial connection between these two muscles. The other side, okay? This is right side, this is left side. Okay, it's going like this. Then, this external oblique myofascial connection can go to this zigzag muscle. What is it? This is serratus anterior. Serratus anterior from external oblique. External oblique from internal oblique. Okay, this myofascial connection is important for core stability. You know, you use core for everything, every movement, right? When you do sports, when you run, when you throw a ball, when you kick ball, and when you do a daily activity, it's very, very important. Now you understand this myofascial connection. Now you can add up, I just explained before. Like, when your feet are on, maybe these guys can do a rotational movement, which are on anatomy books. But when your feet are off, maybe that rotation changes, right? You can use this kind of information for your career. If you are a personal trainer, maybe you can apply this information for your career. Maybe you are a physiotherapist, you can use this logic for your patient, right? And if you see this information is very valuable, I am very, very glad. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.